डियर स्टूडेंट्स, कल हमने 11th क्लास के एक टॉपिक पे चर्चा की थी और टॉपिक था हमारा एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डायमेंशन फॉर्मूला। आज हम उसकी सेकंड एप्लीकेशन देखते हैं कि डायमेंशन फॉर्मूले की सेकंड एप्लीकेशन क्या है। कल हमने बात की थी कि किसी भी फॉर्मूले की वैलिडिटी को चेक करना है तो हमें डायमेंशन फॉर्मूले की ज़रूरत पड़ती है। कोई भी एक फॉर्मूला आपको गिवन होगा, एक उसकी वो डायमेंशनल जो आपकी इक्वेशन दी मिलेगी उसका अगर लेफ्ट साइड और राइट साइड के डायमेंशन फॉर्मूले अगर इक्वल आते हैं तो वो फॉर्मूला हमारा वैलिड है। अगर हमारे लेफ्ट साइड के डायमेंशन फॉर्मूला और लेफ्ट साइड के डायमेंशन फॉर्मूला अगर मैच नहीं करते तो वो फॉर्मूला डायमेंशनली इनकरेक्ट होगा। अगर वो दोनों की इक्वेशन अगर मैच होती हैं तो इस प्रिंसिपल को हम प्रिंसिपल ऑफ होमोजेनिटी भी बोलते हैं। तो आइए देखते हैं हम सेकंड एप्लीकेशन को। टू चेक द वैलिडिटी ऑफ गिवन फॉर्मूला, दिस इज द सेकंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डायमेंशन फॉर्मूला। वी आर गिवन ए इक्वेशन और फॉर्मूला, वी वॉन्ट टू चेक इट इज करेक्ट और नॉट, इट इज वैलिड और नॉट। सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ डायमेंशन फॉर्मूला वी check their existence, it is correct or not according to dimension. So by using the principle of homogeneity, the question, we understand this with the help of question. Question is test the dimensional consistency of the formula for the equation of motion. This is first equation of motion and this is second equation of motion, we know very well. We want to check these are exactly correct or not according to the dimension formula. So आप हमारे इस वीडियो को पूरा देखें। जब आप वीडियो पूरा देखेंगे तो उस समय आपको बिल्कुल क्लियर हो जाएगा कि हम चाहते क्या हैं। और इस आप एक बात दिमाग में रखें कि इस तरह के क्वेश्चन है जो ये टॉपिक इतना इंपॉर्टेंट है कि आप कोई भी कॉम्पिटिशन एग्जाम दें, चाहे नीट का एग्जाम दें, चाहे जेई का एग्जाम दें, एक क्वेश्चन यहाँ से बनता है। आप इसलिए इसको थोड़ा सा बारीकी से देखें। अगर आपने अभी चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया तो हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर दें, इसको ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बच्चों को शेयर करें ताकि सबको इसका बेनिफिट मिल सके। तो आइए देखते हैं हम कैसे वैलिडिटी करेंगे। हम इसके फर्स्ट पार्ट को देखते हैं। फर्स्ट पार्ट, गिवन फॉर्मूला V इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस ए टी। फर्स्ट हमें ये पता होना चाहिए कि V क्या है। This is final velocity of an object. U, initial velocity. A, acceleration. Or T is time. We know very well in this formula V, U, A and T stand for final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration of an object and T stand for time. We want to calculate its different part. This is left part, left side is equal to right side. If it is correct, then formula exists. If this condition incorrect, formula do not exist. First we take the left side. Dimension formula for velocity V is, we know very well velocity is have the formula displacement upon time, displacement be the length and time be t. So we write length into L and in time into t, so its dimension formula is L1 t minus 1. This is the dimension formula. Right side, there are two terms in right side. First term is u and other is at. Dimension formula for u is equal to, this is velocity, so it has the same dimension as this L1T minus 1. Dimension formula for AT is, A is acceleration. We know very well that acceleration have the formula velocity upon time. Dimension formula of velocity is LT minus 1, and this is time, it also have T, so its dimension formula is L1T minus 2. This is the dimension formula of acceleration only. This is acceleration, so it has LT minus 2. But here is time, time have dimension formula T1 and rearrange LT minus 1. This is the dimension formula of this part. On combining both terms in right side, u plus at has dimension formula, both term. This also have the dimension formula LT minus 1. This term also have the dimension formula LT minus 1. और हमने इसकी property में पढ़ा था कि दो physical quantity को अगर हम add करते हैं और उनके dimension formula same है, तो dimension formula पे उसके answer के कारण, addition और subtraction के कारण कोई effect नहीं पड़ता, सिर्फ उसके magnitude change होता है. तो ये भी LT minus 1 और ये भी LT minus 1. So final answer is LT minus 1. This is the dimension formula of right side. Put into this formula. Right side and left side both have the dimension formula as, this is the left side and left side have the dimension formula LT minus 1. This is equation first. And on combining term of right side have the dimension formula also, represented by equation second. So compare first and second, we get, compare equation first and second. So left side is equal to right side. It mean that if left side and right side have the same dimension formula, it means that this given formula or given equation is correct according to dimension equation. So now similar, we solve this second equation and we see that this equation also exists or not, or it is correct or incorrect according to dimension formula. We see that in here S is stand for displacement. This stand for displacement. U stand for initial velocity. T stand for time. A stand for acceleration. These are the terms have meaning in this equation. S stand for displacement, U stand for initial velocity, T stand for time, A stand for acceleration. Here left hand side of this equation have the quantity only one, displacement. So dimensional formula of S is, this is L, because displacement is also a distance, and distance measured into the fundamental quantity length, and length represented by the capital L. In right hand side we see that there are two terms, first and second term. We take dimensional formula
of ut, this term, formula of ut. U is velocity and t is time. We know very well dimension formula of velocity is L t minus 1, and dimension formula of time is t. Rearrange this. This has plus 1 power, this has minus 1 power. Base is same, then power can be added. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. So it became L1 t 0, or we can say that it has dimension formula L1. Dimension formula of half a t square term. This is the second term, half a t square. 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is pure number, and we know very well pure number do not have dimension. So 1 by 2 have not dimension. A be the S relation. We know very well that S relation is velocity upon time, and dimension formula of S relation is L t minus 2. This is the dimension formula of S relation, and here is t square. Dimension formula is t, and we take it square. Rearrange, this is 2 plus power, and if this is 2 minus power, it also became L1 t 0, and we write as L1. In left side, there are two terms. One is in right side, there are two terms, ut and half it is square. Then on combining, then dimension formula for half ut plus half at square, on combine of for ut plus half at square is, this has the dimension formula, we know L1, and this also have the dimension formula L1, and we know very well that when two or more quantity have same dimension formula, they are added or subtracted, there is no effect on the dimension formula of resultant quantity. So resultant dimension is L1. Now we see that dimension dimensional formula of left hand side is equal to right hand side. Left hand side have the dimension formula L, and right hand side also have the dimension formula L1. So dimension formula in right side or left side are same, then this equation we can say it is dimensionally correct. In this way we solve this equation, and any question given and we want to check the correctness of formula based on dimensional equation, in this way we can check that formula. That formula is dimensionally valid or not, we can check by using this method. So here equation S is equal to ut plus half at square is correct according to the dimension formula. The third application of dimensional formula is to stabilize the formula by dimensional method. With the help of dimension formula, we stabilize a formula. Hum ek formula banayenge dimension formula ka use karke. Yani iski third application, humne do application padhi. Ek humne last video mein jaake aap dekh sakte hain. First application thi conversion of one system of unit into another system of unit. And second, humne abhi to validity of given formula. And last application and third application is to form a new formula with the help of dimension formula. We understand this concept with the help of this question, and all questions are similar to this. So the question is, the frequency n, representation of frequency is solution, given is frequency n of vibration of wire depend on First, length of wire, length L. This is the length of wire. Tension T. And mass per unit length. Unit length small m. Mean frequency be the function of these. Suppose frequency of the given wire be proportional to the different power of different functions. Here frequency be the function of length, but we do not know how much the power, how much the exponent of this length, but it depend on length, it depend on tension. We do not know what will be the power of tension in this formula, and it also depend on mass per unit volume, mass per unit length, but we do not know what will be the power of this mass per unit length affect this frequency. We consider, suppose frequency be the function of L, T and M. L have the power A, power B and power C. Let us consider, because we do not know what will be the exponent of these L, T and M. Let us consider they have the power different, and we consider power A, B and C. Find out the value of A, B, C and put into this, we get the formula. We remove this proportionality, then a new constant K comes here. This is LA, TB, MC. This is the equation. First, with the help of dimension formula, we derive the formula of this frequency. So first we know the dimension formula of L, T and M. L be the length, so its dimension formula is M0, L1 and T0, because length have length represented by capital L only. This is frequency. Frequency have the dimension of, we know very well, frequency be the reciprocal of time period. So it is reciprocal of time period, mean its dimension formula is M0, L0, T minus 1, reciprocal of time. This is tension. Tension means force on the wire. Tension means force, and force have the dimension formula M1, L1, T minus of 2. And last, mass per unit length. It is not mass, it is mass per unit length. So dimension formula is M1, L minus 1 and T0. These are the dimension formulas of these quantities separately. We put into equation first and compare, we get N have the dimension formula M0, L0, T minus 1. We put here is equal to K. K is constant and pure number do not have any dimension formula. We know very well pure number do not have any dimension formula. So it has not any dimension. L be the length and length have the dimension formula. This we write here M0, L1, T0 and power is A. Here power is A. T be the tension, not time. Tension have the formula M1, L1, T minus 2 and its power is B. And last, mass per unit length have the dimension formula M1, L minus 1, T0 power of C. We rearrange. First we take M. If base is same, then power must be added. We take M as here M have the power 0 into A, 0. This is 0 plus. This have the power 1. Here have B. 1 into B is B. And last, here is 1 into C is C. So power must be added. L have the power, here is 1, 1 into A, this became A. Here L is 1 and 1 is into B is B plus B. Here L is minus 1 into C minus C. We write here minus C. And T, 0 into A is 0. Here minus 2 into B is minus 2B. Here also 0 into C plus 0. We rearrange as M, B plus C. L have the power A plus B minus C, and T have the power minus 2B. Here is M 0, L 0, T minus 1. This formula is correct according to dimensional condition. So dimension in left side and right side must be equal. This is the formula of homogeneity, mean principle of homogeneity. Dimension formula to right and left side must be same. So compare the power of left and right hand side. Power of M is, here M is 0, here is B plus C. So 0 is equal to B plus C. Compare power of M, L and T on both side. M, L, T on both side. So here is power of M is 0. Here is B plus C. So B plus C must be equal to 0. B plus C is equal to 0. This is first equation. We can say that it is second equation. Compare the power of L. Here is 0. Here A, B and C. Second is A plus B minus C is equal to 0. This is next equation. And last, here is minus 1, here is 2B. Last is minus 1 is equal to minus 2 of B. We write as, we put here as like this, A plus B minus C is equal to 0, and third is minus 1 is equal to minus 2B. We write as. Minus 1 is equal to minus 2b. After solving these equations individual, here minus cancel to minus and b is equal to 1 by 2. This is the value of b. This is the value of b. We compare this equation, add those equations, add. This is first, second equation, this is third equation. This is fourth equation, we write as. Add equation second and third, then B plus C, when we add this equation and this equation as B plus C is equal to 0 and this is A plus B minus C is equal to 0, when they added this cancel to this, it became A plus 2B is equal to 0. Put value of B from here. We put value of B from here to here. We get A plus 2, B is 1 by 2 is equal to 0. A plus 1 is equal to 0 and A is equal to minus 1. We find out the value of A and B. Put the value of A and B into the equation third, we get equation C. Or we put the value of B into equation second, then we easily calculate. Third is put value of B is equal to 1 by 2 into equation second. This is the equation second. Here put the value of B. Then 1 by 2 plus C is equal to 0 and C is equal to minus 1 by 2. In this way, we solve these three equations, second, third and fourth, we solve these equations and find out the value of A, B and C. after solving or after find out the value of A, B and C, put into equation first. This is the basic equation. Put here value of these. So we write here the formula. We write here the formula as put value into equation first. Put into equation first, n became, this is k, a have the power minus 1, l minus 1, t, b have the value 1 by 2, and m have the power, mean value of c is minus 1 by 2, we put here. This is the formula. Rearrange this. N is equal to k. This L have the power minus 1, so goes to downward, T half upward, and M half downward. And N is equal to K upon L root of T by M. This is the answer. In this way, this is answer. In this way, we draw the formula with the help of dimension formula. It is very easy. First given terms we write here and find out their dimension formula. Then the question is, this is supposed part. Suppose n be the function of these have the different power represented by a, b and c. Then put the dimension formula of n, l, k and t and m here. We rearrange in this way. After that, compare both side their power. We compare power of M, L and T on the both side and get the three equation as. These are the three equation, first, second and third. After solving these equation, find out the value of A, B and C. If we know the value of A, B and C, put into equation first and draw the formula as like this. This is the method to stabilize the formula with the help of dimension formula. So main ummeed karta hu ki aapko dimension formula ki sari teeno ki teen application aapko samajh mein aayi hongi. Agar ek baar mein samajh nahi aayi to video ko dobara dekh lo.